Hello, dear friends. Myself, Dr. Lakshman R. Rathod. I am working as an assistant professor in Department of Botany, Mahatma Phule, ASC College, Panvel. I am going to present this topic on general characters of phycomycetes. About phycomycetes. The name of phycomycetes has been subsequent from two Greek words, phyco means seaweeds, mycetes means fungi, hence they are commonly known as algal fungi. The perfect stage usually consisting of zygospores or oospores. The chlamydospores are intercalary, thick-walled structure resemble to echinets of algae. The phycomycete includes about 130 genera and 1,500 species, of which 51 genera and 193 species are recruited from India. Occurrence means what? Where is located of phycomycetes or habitat of phycomycetes fungi. The phycomycetes fungi which are grow in a terrestrial, aquatic as well as in amphibious in nature, for example Phytophthora, Rhizopus and Saprolegnia. In phycomycetes fungi, some fungi are live as parasites and some fungi grow as a saprophytes. The parasitic fungi, for example, Pythium, Phytophthora, and Albigo, while some saprophytic fungi, which are grow on dead and decaying organic material, for example, Rhizopus. Now, about thallus structures of phycomycetes. Okay, so first of all, what is meant by mycelium? The bunch group of hypi is known as a mycelium. The mycelium is primitive, which are simple, unicellular. In some advanced form, a few root-like rhizoids are produced for anchoring the uninucleus thallus to its substratum. Example, in Citridium. In most of the cases, the thallus is aseptate, sinusitic, branched, multinucleus. Example, in Phytophthora, Albigo, and Pythium. Dear friends, you can see the different pictures of parasitic fungi as well as saprophytic fungi. Okay, you can see the first picture, late blight of potato caused by Phytophthora infestans. White rust of mustard caused by Albigo candida and Cystopus candida. The third figure shows the damping of mustard caused by Pythium debranium. And fourth is fungi is Rhizopus, which are grow on dead and decaying organic materials. The Rhizopus fungi actually grow on bread. Hence, they are also known as a bread mold fungi. You can see the reproductions. In lower phycomycetes fungi, the reproduces asexually as well as sexually. Now let us see the first asexual reproduction. In phycomycetes fungi, the asexual reproduction takes place by formation of different types of spores. The spores such as sporangiophore, conidia, chlamydospores and oidia. Now you can see the figure asexual reproduction in Rhizopus. Okay, the first is the rhizoid. They are present at the base of the stolon. On the stolon, the sporangiophore or sporium. Inside the sporangium, the large number of non-motile actinospores are there. Now another asexual reproduction in Pythium also. Another, the same asexual reproduction Pythium. Yes, you can see the sporangiophore. What is in the sporangiophores? It is asexual spores which are produced endogenously in a special sac-like structure, reproductive organ called sporangium. There are two types of sporangium, zoospores and aplanospores. Okay, you can see the first zoospores. The zoospores are oval, flagellated. The flagella are present the both sides. Both sides means what? They are present anterior side as well as posterior sides. Okay, in some fungi, for example Citridiomycetes and Hypocitridiomycetes, the unicellular flagella are present. Uni means single. The single flagella are present on located on the both sides. Okay, while in some fungi the flagella are present, biflagellated zoospores are present. For example, Oomycetes fungi and Plasmodiophoromycetes fungi. Biflagellate means the two types of flagella are there, such as uniflagellate, tinsel type of flagella and V-plus type of flagella. Both the flagella are located at the anterior sides. Example is Oomycetes fungi. Dear friends, you can see the aplanospores, second type of spores, that is a aplanospores. So where is present aplanospores? They are present inside the sporangium, the large number of aplanospores which are non-motile. For example, in nuker and rhizopus also. Now second, that is a conidia. Conidia is also asexual spores are there, which are present in prunospora and alveo. Okay. The conidia are present on the conidiophores. So from the conidiophore, at the maturity stage on the conidiophore, the conidia are separated and they can carried by wind. In unfavorable condition, the conidia will not germinate, while in the favorable condition, the conidia, favorable means what? Sufficient moisture, water or climate conditions is there, then the conidia are germinate to form the germinator. Finally, they are germinate on the new thallus. Some mycologists call them conidia sporangia. Now, second type of spores, asexual spore, that is a chlamydospores, which are thick walled, resting, and intercalate cells called the chlamydospores. Example in rhizopus also and phytophthora also this. Okay, Podia. Podia is also asexual spores present in a mucus also there. You can see another reproduction, that is a sexual reproductions. The sexual, it ranges from isogamy, oogamy and anisogamy. Okay, the sexual reproductions has three types, such as planogametic copulation, gametangel contact and gametangel copulation. Dear friends, you can see the planogametic copulation. Okay, in these methods, the fusion of two naked free gametes, one of both of which may motile, the motile gametes are called planogametes. Okay, then depending on the size and motility of the fusing gametes, there are three types, such as isoplanogametic copulation, anisoplanogametic copulation and euplanogametic copulations. You can see the first, now let us see the first isoplanogametic copulations. Means what? When the two gametes are of same size, same shape and size, they are isoplanogametic copulation. Same means, iso means same. Okay. For example, in Ulpidium, Plasmodiophora. So another type, anisoplanogametic copulations. In this, two gametes are morphologically similar but different in size. Example in Allomyces. Okay. Now third is a heteroplanogametic copulation. It is also known as a euplanogametic copulations. In this, the fusion of motile male gamete with non-motile gametes. Okay. The motile gametes, the anthrozites, enter the oogonium and fertilization the egg or oospores. Example, Monovipularis. Now, second part of sexual reproduction is a gametangel contact. So, in this type, the plasmogamy takes place. What is mean by plasmogamy? The fusion of two protoplasma of both sex organ, male as well as female. Okay, the male gamete is usually represented the male nucleus, the nucleus contained inside the antheridium, while the female gamete is represented by eggs contained in the oogonium. When two gametangia come in contact, the male gamete, the male gametic nuclei migrate into the female nucleus either through a pore dissolve at the point of contact or through a fertilization tube specially developed for the purpose by the male gametangia. Example, Pythium, albigo and Phytophthora. Now last type of reproduction is the gametangial copulations. In case of terrestrial fungi, the gametic union is brought by the fusion between the gametangia. The united gametangia lose their identity in the sexual act. This kind of gamete union is called gametogenic copulation. Example, rhizopus, mucor, and endogenous lactiferum. In phycomycetes, the plasmogamy is immediately followed by karyogamy. What is karyogamy? Division of the nucleus. Karyo means nuclear, gamma means gametes, male and female gametes. Okay. Now, in this last part, that is a germination of zygospore in the phycomycetes. The zygospores or oospores produce as a result of sexual union invert itself with a thick wall and undergoes period of rest. The zygotes or zygospore directly germinate by the formation of germ tube, function as a zoosporangium, producing zoospores. Okay. While the zoospores are germinate in the favorable condition, form the new thallus. Okay. Now about classifications. The classification of phycomycetes. Dr. Sparrow in 1949, and other regard the number of type of flagella, that is zoospores, as a good phylogenetic criteria. The phycomycete belonging to three development series, such as first series is a uniflagellate. Uni means single flagella. We have studied in earlier general character of the phycomycete. What is the uniflagellate or biflagellate? Uni means single type of flagella, which are located both the side, either anterior as well as posterior sides. Okay. Biflagellate means here, second series biflagellate, that is a zoospores biflagellates. There's two type flagella. One is a tinsel type, another is a whipless types. The third series is a planet. Here, the motile zoospores lackings. Lacking means the absence of flagella. For example, in haplanospores. In haplanospores, the spores are non-motiles. Okay. According to MacLean and Cook in 1956, have divided into eight orders, namely as Cetridiales, Uncyclistales, Saprolegials, Blastocladiales, Monobiflariales, Pyrenosporales, Mucorales, and Endothorales. According to recent classification, Alexopoulos in 1956, he divided into six classes on the basis of presence or absence of motile cells in the life cycles. Okay. These class are Cetridiales, example in Syn Cetridium endobioticum, Rhizopidium, Olpidium. Second class is the Monobiflariales, Monobiflaris. Third, Plasmodiophorales, Plasmodiophora. Saprolegials, Saprolegnia, Achyla, Pyrenosporales. Pythium, Albigo, Pyrenospora, Mucorales. Mucor, Rhizopus, Phyllolobus. In this text, the classification proposed by Alexopoulos is found as it is more convenient, standard, and popular all over the world. Thank you, dear student.